This is the Music History Today podcast for August 15th. On today's show, the Beatles go to Shea, the Macarena gets unleashed, and Woodstock begins. First up, though, on this date in 1939, the movie musical The Wizard of Oz premiered in Hollywood. In 1956, Colonel Tom Parker became Elvis Presley's manager. In 1958, Buddy Holly married Maria Elena Santiago. In 1960, Detroit's Cobo Arena opened. The arena was famous for all of the live albums that were recorded there, including ones from KISS and Bob Seger. In 1965, the Beatles performed at Shea Stadium in New York City, a very famous concert. In 1969, the Woodstock Music Festival began. The first official performer was Richie Havens. In 1975, the movie musical The Rocky Horror Picture Show premiered. In 1980, George Harrison released his autobiography, I, Me, Mine. In 1981, a man was shot and killed while returning home from a Stevie Wonder concert in California. Soon thereafter, the man's girlfriend received a gift from Stevie himself. It was Stevie's gold record for his album at the time, Hotter Than July. In 1983, Paul Simon married actress Carrie Fisher. In 1990, The Verve played live for the first time. In 1991, during a concert in Los Angeles, California, Nirvana invited the audience to show up for their music video shoot that they were shooting a few days later. That video was for the song Smells Like Teen Spirit, which of now, of course, has become a classic music video. In 1998, Richie Havens performed at the Day in the Garden Festival in Bethel, New York. In 2003, the TV musical movie The Cheetah Girls premiered on television. In 2004, Fish played their last show for 5 years. In 2005, Leonard Cohen sued his former manager for $5 million for mishandling the money that was pushed aside for his retirement. In 2007, the Osmonds reunited for the first time in almost 20 years and performed at their televised 50th anniversary concert. In 2008, the group U-KISS was formed. In 2009, U2 broke the attendance record at Wembley Stadium in London when 89,000 people attended that concert. The old record at Wembley was set in 1995 by Rod Stewart with 83,000 people. And in 2012, three members of the group Baroness were injured in a tour bus accident. In theater, in 1988, the revival of the musical Ain't Misbehavin' opened on Broadway, and in 1993, the musical The Goodbye Girl closed on Broadway. Albums that were released on August 15th include in 1966 when Chad and Jeremy released Distant Shores. In 1969, Fleetwood Mac released Pious Bird of Good Omen. In 1972, the band released Rock of Ages. In 1975, Rod Stewart released Atlantic Crossing. In 1978, the Scorpions released Tokyo Tapes. In 1979, Led Zeppelin released their album In Through the Outdoor. It was their last studio album before drummer John Bonham passed away. In 1980, America released Alibi, and the Cars released Panorama. In 1981, the Kinks released Give the People What They Want, and the Pretenders released Pretenders 2. In 1983, Cheap Trick released Next Position Please, and AC/DC released Flick of the Switch. In 1985, Dio released Sacred Heart. In 1988, Michelle Shocked released Short, Sharp, Shocked, and Glenn Frey released Soul Searching. In 1989, the Rolling Stones released the singles collection The London Years. In 1995, Southern Culture on the Skids released Dirt Track Date, Garbage released their self-titled debut album, and Blind Melon released Soup. In 1998, Korn released Follow the Leader. In 2000, Blue October released Consent to Treatment. In 2006, Ringo Starr released Ringo Starr and Friends. In 2007, Little Dragon released their self-titled album. And in 2009, The Sparks released The Seduction of Ingmar Bergman. Singles that were released in the UK on August 15th include in 1965 when Donovan released The Universal Soldier, in 1980 The Jam released Start, and in 1983 REM released their debut single there, Radio Free Europe. Meanwhile in America, in 1965 Otis Redding released Respect before Aretha Franklin's version of the song. In 1968, Big Brother and the Holding Company released Peace of My Heart. In 1987, John Mellencamp, then known as John Cougar Mellencamp, released Paper and Fire. In 1989, Aerosmith released Love in an Elevator. In 1995, Michael Jackson released You Are Not Alone. REM released Crush with Eyeliner. And the Bayside Boys remix of the Macarena from Los Del Rio was unleashed upon an unsuspecting world, becoming the biggest selling song of the 1990s. And in 2002, No Doubt released Underneath It All. Before we go any further, we'd like to tell you that there is now a Music History in Depth podcast where we go more in depth on a few of the events that happened in music history for that particular week. The Music History in Depth podcast runs every Tuesday on YouTube or wherever you get your podcasts from, as does our Music Halls of Fame podcast, which talks about a member of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame along with other Music Halls of Fame, museums, and walks of fame. The Music Halls of Fame podcast drops every Thursday and can also be found on YouTube or wherever you get your podcasts. Now, back to this podcast. Artists who were born on August 16th include Joe Jonas of the Jonas Brothers and DNCE. Also rapper Chief Keef, rapper Nipsey Hussle, singer Tones and I, Ted Duane of Mumford & Sons, drummer Tristan Evans of the group The Vamps, singer Belinda, rapper D-Lo, singer Natalia Kills, Matt Johnson of The, Mikey Graham of Boyzone, Tim Foreman of Switchfoot, Styx Hooper of The Crusaders, the legendary singer Mr. Bobby Caldwell, Tom Johnston of the Doobie Brothers, Pete York of the Spencer Davis Group, country music's musician Don Rich of Buck Owens' backup band, the Buckaroos, country music singer Bobby Helms, singer Johnny Thunder, jazz musician Oscar Peterson, Bill Pinkney of the group The Drifters, singer Rose Maddox of the Maddox Brothers and Rose, Eddie Phillips of The Creation, songwriter Jimmy Webb, drummer Tommy Aldrich of Whitesnake and also of Ozzy Osbourne's band, Mike Somerville of Head East, the inventor of the theremin electronic instrument, Mr. Leon Theremin, songwriter Ned Washington, composer Hugo Winterhalter, singer Jackie Brenston, Floyd Ashton of the group The Tams, Mark Marish of the Fabulous Wailers, legendary singer and musician Mr. Buster Brown, Bobby Day of the Hollywood Flames, drummer Gunther Sommer, Marcia Stofield of The Fall, Simon Darburn of 9/11, saxophonist Georgie Garanyan, and composer Charles Tobias. Artists who unfortunately passed away on August 15th include composer Johann Serranus, who passed away in 1600 at the age of 60. Composer Marin Marias passed away in 1728 at the age of 72. Composer Felice Alessandri passed away in 1798 at the age of 50. Composer Timothy Olmsted passed away in 1848 at the age of 88. Composer Giovanni Poledro passed away in 1853 at the age of 72. Violinist Joseph Joachim passed away in 1907 at the age of 76. Composer Anatoly Viadov passed away in 1914 at the age of 59. Composer Heinrich Sokolitz passed away in 1918 at the age of 64. Composer Gerard Falk passed away in 1935 at the age of 75. Opera singer Henry Litton passed away in 1936 at the age of 71. Pianist Artur Schnabel passed away in 1951 at the age of 69. Ragtime singer Blind Willie McTell passed away in 1959 at the age of 61. Blues guitarist Styx McGee passed away from cancer in 1961 at the age of 43. Composer John Powell passed away in 1963 at the age of 80. Singer Jan Kiapura passed away from heart issues in 1966 at the age of 64. Composer Edward Kalenyi Sr. passed away in 1968 at the age of 84. Composer Carl Anderson passed away in 1970 at the age of 66. Singer Thomas Wayne passed away in a car accident in 1971 at the age of 31. Composer Alf Hurum passed away in 1972 at the age of 89. Composer Harrison Kerr passed away in 1978 at the age of 80. Recording engineer Norman Petty passed away in 1984 at the age of 57. Composer Richard Yardumian passed away in 1985 at the age of 68. Composer Richard E. Holes passed away in 1986 at the age of 74. Victor Soy of the group Kino passed away in a car accident in 1990 at the age of 28. Country music singer Lou DeWitt passed away from Crohn's disease in 1990 at the age of 52. Songwriter Jackie Edwards passed away from heart issues in 1992 at either the age of 53 or 54. His birth date is unknown. Jazz pianist Yerby Bowser passed away in 1995 at the age of 77. Pianist Lupka Kolesa passed away in 1997 at the age of 95. Songwriter Gösta Sundvik passed away from heart issues in 2003 at the age of 46. Opera singer Samiha Berksoy passed away in 2004 at the age of 74. Recording engineer and producer Dave Hassinger passed away in 2007 at the age of 80. Opera conductor Richard Bradshaw passed away in 2007 at the age of 63. The music producer who coined the term rhythm and blues and worked with Aretha Franklin, Led Zeppelin, Bob Dylan, among others, Rock and Roll Hall of Famer Jerry Wexler passed away in 2008 at the age of 91. Producer Jim Dickinson passed away in 2009 at the age of 67. Lyricist Betty Thatcher passed away from cancer in 2011 at the age of 67. Musician Bob Birch of Elton John's band committed suicide in 2012 at the age of 56. The opera singer with the New York Metropolitan Opera from 1940 to 1966, Licia Albanese, passed away in 2014 at the age of 105. The manager of both Wham and also Snow Patrol, Jazz Summers, passed away in 2015 at the age of 71. Vibraphonist Bobby Hutcherson passed away in 2016 at the age of 75. And composer Joel Eric Subin passed away in 2023 at the age of 77. Next on the Music History Today podcast, it is August 16th, when in 1977, the King of Rock and Roll passes away. And in 2018, the Queen of Soul does the same thing.